open too wide. Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like
Good day, everyone. Praying for each of you today. Welcome to Spiritual Life with Pastor X. It's going to be a good one today. It's going to be a good one. It's going to be a good one. I trust that you're well. God bless you. God bless you. Spiritual Lunch. Pastor X. Come on in. Shout out from Garden Grove. God bless you. God bless you. God bless each of you. Well, God bless each of you on today. Welcome to Spiritual Lunch. This is Pastor X, and I am glad that you have tuned in, joined us today for some spiritual edification. Listen, if you are anywhere in the Southern California area on this coming Sunday, 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock, and 3 o'clock, we're having a parking lot praise party at each of our locations. 9 o'clock at the St. Paul Baptist Church of Pacoima, 12 o'clock at the Calvary Baptist Church, and then 3 o'clock at the Southern Missionary Baptist Church. Listen, it's going to be fire. It's going to be epic. Don't worry about the sun. We have prepared with you in mind. We have tents. We have canopies. All of that good stuff that you will not be in the sun, though we are in the parking lot. Then we have food trucks, vendors that's going to be here, and it is all free of charge. You heard it right, free of charge. I wanted to do something in all of these campuses to show my appreciation, to show the appreciation of the leadership of these ministries, of how grateful I am to God. Listen, it's 6 months and counting that we've been away from each other. You've been faithful in your support. You've been faithful in your generosity, your financial contribution, your prayers, your covering. The least we can do is give back to you. We're going to social distance. We're going to take temperatures. We're going to be masked up. We're going to comply in the spirit of obedience and excellence, and we're going to have a good time. And in Jesus' name, I'm pleading the blood of Jesus, none will be lost, that we all will be protected and we all will be well. The last time I left off with you, I began this issue of teaching, this topic of teaching, entitled Maintaining Your Integrity. I want to pick up where I left off. Maintaining your integrity. When Paul penned the second epistle to the Corinthians in Corinth, it was a comprehensive letter of self-defense, of he was defending his apostleship. He was defending his authority as a leader. He was defending the assault on his reputation, on his character. And the bottom line, it came down to him maintaining his integrity. Spiritual hypocrisy. Listen, spiritual lunch with Pastor X today. A long way to go, a short time to get there. Spiritual hypocrisy is much easier than spiritual integrity. Life teaches us that. Our journey teaches us that. Watch what you say, that it matches who you are and it matches what you do. What you say and who you are must match who you really are. In the old church, your talk must match your walk, because spiritual hypocrisy is much easier than spiritual integrity. A hypocrite, when we deal with hypocrisy, that word hypocrite is one who is a play actor, one who wears a costume, one who plays a role, one who identity is concealed by a facade. People, ladies and gentlemen, are enamored and become very, very excited about the external. I want you to make sure that your internal matches your external. Do you get that? People become enamored. People become excited about the bells, the whistles, the trappings. They are excited about the outward appearance. Spiritual lunch with Pastor X today. Make sure that you are just as beautiful on the inside as you are on the outside. Make sure that you are just as loving, just as attractive on the inside as you are on the outside. Be careful when it comes to integrity. Be careful, because it is easy to fake it. Spiritual hypocrisy is much easier than spiritual integrity. The tragedy of spiritual hypocrisy is that not only does it stain our witness, the tragedy of spiritual hypocrisy is that it gives God a bad name. That's what I want to challenge you today. Do not give God a bad name. Don't give God a bad name with your behavior. Do not give God a bad name with your communication. Do not give God a bad name with your lifestyle. Do not give God a bad name with anything that is attached to you. The tragedy, the problem with spiritual hypocrisy is that it stains your witness, it stains your credibility, and it gives God a bad name. Spiritual hypocrisy gives the kingdom a bad name. It gives you a bad name. Proverbs chapter 22 and verse number 1, the Bible says that a good name is to be chosen over wealth. A good name is to be chosen over riches. I'd rather have a good name than a pair of Gucci shoes. I'd rather have a good name than some red bottoms. I'd rather have a good name than a big house. A good name than luxurious cars. Proverbs chapter 22, verse number 1, a good name is to be chosen over wealth. What does people call you? What do people call you? Huh? What do they call you? What do they know you by? Do they know you by pure? Do they know you by honest? Do they know you by sincere? Or do they know you by shady? Do they know you by untrustworthy? Do they know you by, oh, that's a deceiver? That one doesn't have a good name. What do people know you by? A good name is to be chosen over wealth. Favor is better than silver and gold. Spiritual lunch with Pastor X today. I want to challenge you to maintain your integrity, okay? Hypocrisy. The opposite of maintaining your integrity is hypocrisy. Either you are walking in integrity or you are walking in hypocrisy. You cannot walk in both simultaneously. I need you to get that. Either you are living in integrity or you are living in hypocrisy. I need you to get that. Those of you who are in the body of Christ today, I need you to get that. Let me tell you what hypocrisy does. Hypocrisy, it betrays your new identity in Christ. When you were saved, when you took on the Lord Jesus Christ, when you gave God your heart and the preacher your hand, a transformation should have begun in you. I did not say that the transformation was completed. No, it should have begun. Philippians 1 and 6, but he who hath begun a good work in me shall perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Marquise Brown, I love you so much, man, holding it down. I love you so much. Listen, what I want you to understand today, love you, PG, praying for you. What I want you to understand today is that hypocrisy betrays the lifestyle of a Christian. Hypocrisy betrays the new creation in you. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse number 17. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. Now that you're saved, listen. Now that he's called you out of darkness into the marvelous light, you must be sure that you do not compromise this new life. All right? 2 Peter chapter 1, verse number 3. His divine power has given unto us everything required for life and godliness and the knowledge of him who called us by his own glory and goodness. Galatians chapter 2, verse number 20. You know that one. I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me, which the life that I now live in the flesh. What did he say? Paul says, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and delivered himself for me. Now, the tension of your life today, I need you to get this. The tension of your life, the tension of my life, all of us who are saved, all of us who are blood bought, who are born again, the tension of our lives is the temptation to compromise our new self, to compromise our new life that come in and through Christ Jesus. That's the tension of my life. The tension of your life is, watch this, to yield to the temptation that get us in a place of compromise. Listen, the moment you went off, the moment you cussed them out, the moment you blew a fuse, the moment you paid them back, the moment you took vengeance upon yourself, that was the moment the enemy got you in a position of compromise. And you cannot compromise. Listen, you are no longer who you once were. You are no longer who you used to be. He has delivered you from that. He has saved you from that. He has brought you back from that. A dog does not return to his vomit. This is the constant war, beloved, between you and I who are saved. The constant war between you and I who are saved is to go back to our old patterns, our old practices, our old behavior, our old life, and watch this. Do it under the guise of us now being a new creation. That is a hypocrite. The things I used to do, I don't do no more. Places I used to go, I don't go no more. Why? I've been changed. I don't fight my own battles no more. I turn them over to the Lord. I don't seek vengeance on my enemies anymore. I give my enemies over to the Lord. Listen, this is the war. This is the battle. This is the temptation. Is to get you and I. Here it is. Let me break it down. The temptation for you is to get you out of integrity. To get you out of integrity. To get you to compromise. The temptation is to get you to sin. The temptation is your flesh warring against your spirit. The temptation this week for you is, listen, I got this old man and I got this new man on the inside of me, and this old man and this new man are constant at battle, constant warring against each other. Listen, the verdict is, who gonna win today? Who gonna win this week? All right? My old inclinations, my old behaviors, my old proclivities, my old practices versus my new nature. You new creation, you a new creation. No. You don't roll like that. You don't act like that. You don't talk like that. You don't live like that. You are a new creation. And what Paul in 2 Corinthians, I'm going to deal with it on Friday. I got to get back to spiritual gifts tomorrow night with Word Up Wednesday. But Paul, the assault is coming on every hand. The attack is coming on every hand. Now, you know Paul wasn't afraid. He's an ex-gangster. You know Paul wasn't afraid to fight back. He's an ex-killer. He know how to clap back. He know how to fight back. He know how to get his point across. But he's maintaining his integrity. You know what he's saying? He's saying in 2 Corinthians stuff like, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God for the pulling down of strongholds. This is the man, listen, who used to take matters into his own hand. And now he's a new creation. And he said, nope. I ain't fighting you because I don't know how to fight. I don't roll like that no more. Nope. I ain't cussing you out because I don't know what to say. I just don't talk like that no more. Nope. I'm not getting out of character. I'm not getting out of integrity. I'm a new creation. I'm crucified with Christ. And the life that I now live, I live by faith in Him. And let me tell you today, that every victory that you are able to get in your life, what you are doing is building a track record of integrity. Oh, I held my mouth today. I'm building a track record of integrity. Oh, I didn't clap back. I'm building a track record of integrity. Oh, man, I was so mad, I knew who to call, and I knew that he or she would have gave me a good time. They would have scratch where I was itching. But no, I didn't pick up the phone. No, I just kept going on the freeway. I kept going where I was going. I stayed focused. I'm building a track record of integrity. Let's start today. When you have an opportunity to go left, stay focused, build and maintain integrity. See, living with integrity simply means that you are living out this new life in Jesus Christ. Come on, today is a good day to start. Come on, come on. We are both working out our salvation with fear and with trembling. What does it mean to live a life of integrity, to maintain my integrity? It is to stay put, to stay under. Are you listening to me? It means that no. I'm a new creation now. No. I'm a new creature now. No. Living and maintaining integrity means that I'm going to stay focused on being a Christian. Being a Christian, a Christian, a follower of the teaching of the Lord Jesus Christ. Listen, it ain't no easy job, y'all. It ain't no easy job, but no, I gotta build this track record of integrity and live out this new life in Jesus, in Christ Jesus. Now let me close today with this. Your testimony is on the line, okay? Watch what you say, watch how you behave, watch how you react, watch how you respond, watch what you entertain. Why? Your testimony is at stake. Your witness is at stake. Your witness is at stake. Did you hear me? It ain't good enough just to be in church. No. Your witness is at stake. See, everybody in church don't mean just because they're in church, you can say something good on their behalf. Okay? What is their witness? What is your witness? Maintain your integrity, friends. The testimony of the church is at stake based on whether or not you are in spiritual integrity or spiritual hypocrisy. The power of the word of God is at stake. Are you listening to me? The power of the word of God. That's why some people will not even come to church, because they feel like a bunch of play actors is in the church. They feel that Halloween is in the church every week. We saying one thing and doing another. They feel that we're dressed up in costumes. They feel that we are adorned in religiosity, in a facade. But I want to tell you today, based on how you live, determines whether or not your church grows. Based on how you live, determine whether or not your family is healthy. Your ministry is healthy. It's a lot on the line. Your reputation, the reputation of God, the reputation of the kingdom. Your family is on the line. Your marriage is on the line. Your future is on the line. Today is a good day to make sure that you're going to build and maintain integrity. Now, integrity, the root word is integer, whole, undivided. No. God, when I walk in integrity, it means that I'm whole. Nothing missing, nothing broken, undivided. God has my undivided attention. When I walk in integrity, God has, watch this, He has all of me. Complete. Totality. The total me. The whole me. Are you listening to me? Spiritual lunch with Pastor X today. It's been fun, but I got to run. Today is a good day for you to live out integrity. Paul was assaulted. I'm going to go deeper on Friday and give you some scriptures. Paul assaulted. Paul attacked. Listen, this ex-murderer, this ex-gangster, this ex-persecutor who knew how to put his enemies down, he said, no, I don't fight like that no more. No, I don't live like that no more. No, I don't roll like that no more. The weapons of my warfare. He says, I used to get the victory by with guns and bullets, but now I get the victory on my knees. I get the victory fighting in the spiritual realm. I get the victory, watch this, not with carnal weapons, not with carnal weapons. Not listen, please, for the life of me, I beg you, I implore you who are listening to me on this line, give it to Jesus. He can fight better than you can. Put down your carnal weapons. Well, I just got to tell them what's on my mind. No, shut up. Be quiet. Pray about it. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. You stay in integrity. It's fun. I gotta go. This coming Sunday, 9 o'clock North Campus, 12 o'clock the Calvary Baptist Church of Pacoima. Then 3 o'clock we bringing it home big in Los Angeles. It's gonna be on and cracking. I promise you. All of my babies, all of my members, man, these churches are so good to me. I've been inundated with calls. Pastor, be careful. Pastor, you better put your mask on. I mean, I've been having my members spank me. Pastor, you better wash your hands. Pastor, take this. Listen, I love all you all. I'm a rich man. The fact that you love me. I'm a wealthy man. The fact that you're in my life. I promise you, this coming Sunday, we're going to be socially distant. We're going to be masked up. We're going to wash our hands. We're going to take temperatures. We're going to do all that we got to do. In-N-Out Burger Truck. Stone Fry Fire Grill. Havoc Truck Burger. All that good stuff, man. It's coming to our campuses free of charge. Y'all been good to y'all churches. You've been good to these ministries. I've seen you on Friday, Saturday, Sunday, dropping off your tithes, dropping off your pastor's love gift, dropping off your offering, making sure that there's no lack in our houses. And because of that, we giving back to y'all on this coming Sunday. We giving back to you by faith in Jesus' name. Until next time, tomorrow night, Word Up Wednesday, 7 o'clock. All of our digital platforms, St. Paul, Southern, Calvary, website, YouTube, Vimeo, Facebook, all of our digital platforms are going to be blazing hot. I love you. Make it a great day.